terminal illness. My entire aura is sick. A belligerent alcoholic, paraplegic. That means I drink till I can't walk. Suicide king, I outline myself in chalk. I'm no longer to battle it just for reputation. I'm all about airborne plagues and cell mutation. Face it against AIDS to see who lasts the duration. My favorite shade of green is gang.
Yeah, yeah. Chaotic style Z13, motherfucker hungry.
It's 13, then let me host my own show. Erg 7, so love, I headed off the torch. And I'm here to ask what made it. Orders full out the paper and pen disorder. Mental life start writing again. Season 1, Demon Contrail, Little Ratchet, Magnif, New Legends, Erg 7, Habit of God. The Kid Ace, King Nephew, Mike Sir, Black Rock, Blocks, Angel Sandoval. All hustle hard to get money using God-given artistry. Welcome to the Hungry.
Little Rachett.
Oh,
this
shit.
Motherfucker right here, man. Is family. This is my real cousin.
Oh,
brother
shit.
Side. This is sad because my dad's fucking got some history and we don't really talk. Only see this nigga on funerals and maybe weddings. It's all bad, but you know what I mean? But like still, God and the universe and everything brought us back around. We started fucking with Earth 7. Lord be known. Little Rachett been fucking with Earth 7 for years, nigga. You know what I'm saying? We talked last time, we got to link up, do some shit, we tried, you know what I mean? But that was like, everything's right here, family is black. Yes, you know what I mean? I'm excited for this.
It's not the Hungry, I'm glad to be here.
Yeah.
Check it out. I think I'm the host. I'm interviewing my friends with me. I don't think I'm living with a lot of questions, but y'all know me. Tune in to my YouTube shit. You know, motherfucking the panel with the theme music song by my boy Damien Control. I want to go around the room. We got a live studio audience today.
We got people.
So I want to talk to Angel Sandoval, Earl Sir. We got Sir Black in the house. Rock Box, Nephew Michael, my nephew's in the house. G13, Michael Miller somewhere. So yeah, I was talking about first cousins. I'm working on a project that I ain't working on that I'm thinking about that I'm putting in the air. So my first cousin and his first cousin, we all first cousins. That's the name of the group. It ain't even a group. We're individual people. Like I said, it's gonna be G13, Michael Miller, my first cousin. Right now, what I got going is refuse to break. You wanna ask me a question about it? Let's get into that. Refuse to break.
Let's get into that.
They think the earth is flat. Okay, it's flat. Earth. Flat earth. We got flat earth. We got Nephilims, lizard people, shapeshifters. I mean, if you want to believe all that John Lucas shit, go to movie school and learn how to create CGI. And then, whatever, but I ain't into all that. Look, my boss is God. I was working on a mixtape called God First. This is when I met Earth, actually. I haven't been on Earth for years, but let God tell it. That's my brother. We all brothers. So look, let's okay, not Google. Me get on that, because you got to go to my YouTube channel and subscribe.
For every cup
look,
of butter.
Now, Fuse and Break, Nigga Scared. It's like, basically in that song, first I name all my kids and I go into like stuff. So you gotta really listen to songs, it's a story. Each, actually title of the song tells a story, then you gotta listen to the fucking songs then. Actually, you would have to go back to my first album when I signed to Mariah.
I got caught up in Tommy and Tony's divorce.
I was Mariah Carey's first artist, I was a real hip-hop artist, West Coast. It was really big because it was pushing me because I'm kind of after the death of Tupac and Biggie. But it was a lot of other stuff going on. But I noticed after we were doing stuff, I noticed people that were always getting on with the going that wasn't hip-hop looking people and it wasn't even cool, but they were always there. I found out that it was really cool with people. And people want to figure out who fucking the niggas. I'm going to say it like that. That all fell through. But it was called Crave Records. It was her first independent. I think she got something called Mine. Now I don't even follow her anymore. No disrespect, but people ain't doing what they're supposed to be doing. So it fell through. The album actually did come out, but it didn't come out. Because, you know, when in that time, the industry, you know, we had all the labels. And, you know. I mean, yeah, you can find it, but what I mean by that is when we were shopping it, the public didn't know nothing about it. I was hanging out with people like Cigar Master Bird, who at the time had six labels, I forgot, but he had signed cheap little guards and I forgot what it's called. Anyway, I'm on some music, but yeah, there's a lot of stuff going on and it just was like, it was alright. But it wasn't alright because if you stopping me for people that already got their own labels and shit, then once that shit fell through, it wasn't like they was checking for me or trying to, you know, sign me or whatever. They already had this stuff up and going, so yeah, I had to kind of stand for myself. We get a person and distribution of the water, and not, that's all they get. The person the CD, they put it in stores, no promotion or nothing. And we were already kind of independent, you know what I'm saying? So when the divorce went through, we didn't have no distributors. Sony was the distributor only through like the mayor. We were like, you know what I'm saying? After that stuff, Mariah became just a regular person. So, and then she had a little breakdown, put that all in the money. I was trying to figure out if I live on 134th in Vermont in an apartment. And you go around the Rolls Royces getting on national news talking about a breakdown. I don't know who really happened to break that. So it's cool. I'm back with two great niggas scared about all the false lies going on and all the misguided information. We don't got no, like, I'm gonna touch on something that Nephew Michael was talking about. Like, we don't really got no, the youth don't have no role models. The older guys that's out there, they trying to do what the young dudes is doing. So now you got niggas are smoking sherm or whatever else. Now they popping pills and other shit too. So they overdosing, they zombies. These little niggas think they can beat them. Oh man. But anyway, I got a lot of spiritual messages in my album. I know I'm from a nigga, another point, Nephew Michael said. If y'all been watching these interviews, I don't know what episode this is. Like I say, it's a lot of people in here right now. And this episode, Nasty Sass. Nah, man. That shit is a message, man. I don't want to get into it. I would rather y'all listen to it, because everybody going to get their own. They're going to get their own definition of what they're hearing, their own understanding, because it's really in code. All the words are words you learned in school, but I don't speak the same English everybody speaks. I'm not even talking to humans. So if it don't touch your spirit, if my music don't touch your spirit, it wasn't for you. It's probably going to make you mad. I intended to make you mad. I'm mad at a whole bunch of stuff. So it's a lot of my anger
that I'm releasing. Yeah, but that album flowed. And like I've been listening to it, and it's like you touch on like so many different aspects of hip hop. Like you know what I mean. You got the slow like C track. You got, you know what I mean. Like I said, Nigga Scared just teach you like straight up like real shit, like lyric shit. And you got the popping, you know what I mean, with the fat beats and everything. And it's all lyrics. And it's all written. It's all coming through.
Hey, y'all probably know what this is from the side. You probably know the bottle. We can't show the logo, but this is some good shit.
Yeah.
So and I usually put Ciroc in this and whatever, but it's lemonade.
The check, we show the logo.
You need to check your bitches.
And I turn the logo around.
You know what I'm saying?
Other than that, I'm spending my hard-earned money on this shit. This ain't, fuck, I want to plug you for. You ain't get saying, telling me thanks. I ain't seen thank you on none of my receipts. Right. For all these products I've been buying all these years. It's cool though, because I like what I like. And I'm not going to stop buying products I like. You're fortunate. Anyway, hey, this is a hip hop show. I'm hungry for y'all to stream my music. I'm sorry.
Tell me.
Baby cover. So it's a rank thing going on. This is a real show, but I feel like, you know, nigga, what?
Like, you've been rapping all these years. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's the thing that's tripping me out like this.
Right.
Because, like, it's real talk. I only really see you at funerals, which is all sad. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know? But at the same time, you've been doing your thing for years, just like I've been doing my thing for years.
Yeah. Crazy. You know what I'm saying? I wish I would have known, because, like, you know, I went to a show recently, and I was shocked because I don't know what I expected, and it was actually no form of music for me. It's hip hop, and it's not West Coast, like it's music. See, the thing is, I grew up on music. I remember like a couple times earlier in my early career, the first time I was doing it, and I went, oh, real quick. See, when it came into my label, I got a publisher coming, so for all you guys that don't got everything right, you out there, you want to get out there and make it official, then come from the Cito Entertainment, which is Nearside of Cito Incorporated, which is another company that make believe that it's for real, but we're going to put some real shit out there.
Well,
nothing I say is true, but I'm not even real.
Tell them where to get this, what a nation to you.
Man, my major distributor is CDs, baby, but you can get that digitally everywhere.
Yeah, baby, everywhere.
I'm like, Herb, look, you can get it everywhere. Amazon, Tidal, Xbox, Groove Music, Slacker.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I
cracked
my game one time and saw my.
It's crazy shit. Hey, shout out to Earth 7, the Digi God, man. And I'm saying, it's funny how we all actually been around each other. Because I was at my house going through my archives and I pulled out this paper that was on my first album and then it dropped into the top hot new albums. And right above my album was a Macadelic album, which is the group Earth 7 was in.
You don't see how all the
kind of crazy how like everybody in this room right now, even was going to meet our
around each other before and didn't know it. But there's really some good positive spiritual godly energy here. So I hope you like those words. Hey, the dudes that I think are gonna come to my door and kidnap me and take me away, that's something else. Look, so yeah, go to my YouTube channel. Music. I got some features with Earth 7, he got an album All About Stuff. I think I'm gonna be on some more upcoming stuff with Earth. All About Stuff, we got Compton in Minnesota.
Compton in Minnesota, I was banging
that
on the
way.
Yeah, I'm on that.
One of my main producers, 181 Shop and 181. I just dropped something with my bandmates, Dyer Lansky and Wayne G. Shout out to Dyer Lansky, Wayne G. Cole 187, that whole camp. The album's called With Your Bitch Ass. The Too Tight compilation out of Japan. Shout out to Shuji, DJ 2 Fly, everybody out in.
Tokyo.
Estendo. Oh, I love Estendo. Sounds like Estendo gang, Gorilla gang. If I double cross you, it'd probably be like this. So don't ever think I'm a backstabber. Look, this is all good stuff. California. Anyway, what you were saying, I got a lot of stuff to talk about. Who else? Let me not forget nobody. Because I'm going to forget all y'all. So everybody I forget that say, well, you didn't plug me. Well, when I say all y'all that support me, everybody I forgot, that's you. Stupid.
No.
Ask me a question.
Talk to me about the music, man. About the music. Where the soul and like, how has your passion been for all these years? Like, what kept you in? Why do you write rhymes? Why do you go to the studio?
I retired, bro. Look, I stopped doing music when it got weird. The real reason I stopped when the divorce thing and everything happened and I was over there with Warner, I just didn't like, it wasn't handling me right. It's actually like, I can't say that being signed to Riot wasn't a good experience because I had cars coming to get me. I was getting shot to Burbank Airport. I would go to different states and stuff and just be with a whole bunch of, I don't even want to say their names, but all those guys that I'm about to stand back next to and bump you and do all that to, and you're going to be trying to figure out how I got past your security. Because they felt like they were going to lose their job.
What year was this? What was that?
This was,
I first was dealing with them, starting like 95. They were kind of what they call artist development. So they were kind of just, I was recording, doing a lot of, going to clubs for nothing where other major artists were performing. They call that photo ops. But the thing about that is, this is what I didn't like. So I hope you never, other people, I'm glad to say
it's an independent game, but this is what my manager, my handler used to do, which was Mirage's brother. He would say, ooh, there go Usher over there. Go over there and take a picture. If you didn't set it up already, you'd tell him, oh, I'm not going over there, because I'm still a civilian in that nigga. He don't know me. I'm not going over to Usher and tap that nigga and ask him for no motherfucking picture. That's weirdo shit. I'm going to feel weird. Like, I ain't doing that, bro. That ain't set up. Because what if he do that movie star shit, and then now my street shit going to kick in?
Yeah, right. Now they got a picture of that.
It wasn't set up right then. It was a lot of that going on. I had to get used to doing that. I finally got used to just run it over there, and just then I had to get my whole resume. Oh, Mariah, new artist, They always paid me attention when I said that, and I didn't want to always be Mariah's artist or her boy, because at the end of the day,
in that industry at that time, you become people's boys or girls, or you that motherfucker. You never really get your own name. Like, you always got to associate yourself with some other person. I just wanted to be Rachett. Which I stole my own life. I did a lot of stuff they didn't like. I felt like I could have blew up a long time ago.
But tell me about the name
comes from.
Really, it came from my brother getting out of prison. Some dude, let me just go tell a little story. Some dude from Lock Great Street, his homie, he was in the with Big Ike, whatever my brother was doing on his thing, he rapping. So when he got out of jail, that's just my big brother. It turned into some gang shit, but that's where I got it from. That's the real story. But I turned into something else, my rap name. Every letter means something, means rhymes and clout having everything they thought. Now, I don't know what you think I got, but it's whatever you think. You ain't gonna tell me. The rhymes in the clout, you'll see it. You see who I hang around with. Everybody's somebody. Rhymes, I got that. And the clout, yeah, because I don't gotta pay for shit. That's why I be pushing this rhythm shit. I got a lot of shit on my backpack.
There we go.
Got a lot of logos and shit on my backpack. I'm gonna have these guys sign it maybe often, but this shit got a lot of shit that, like, I say, okay, real quick, where y'all can find me? Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Music is on Reverb Nation. I don't have a SoundCloud. And then you can actually go stream it wherever you can search my name and put it in. And you want to purchase it, cool. Hard copies are available through CD Baby. And you can email me at lilratchett@gmail.com. That's lilratchett@gmail.com. And I'll send you some of the ones I got sitting in my warehouse. Which is my living room. I don't think I got no big warehouse. Because like I say, Ron's got everything y'all thought. And then I tell you I got a warehouse. And you probably believe me because I said it. But I'm just saying stuff. Because I write rhymes. I'm an author. I create shit all the time. So don't fall for everything. Not even everything you see. So
what can we expect in the future, man?
In the future, first cousin. That's Mike the Middleman, Lil Rachett, and G13, first cousins. They all related. They really all first cousins. That's really some real shit. You can expect new music with Lil Rachett and Rockbox. Damien Cantrell is an R&B artist I've been writing with for years and collaborating with. He's going to be on every album singing. So if you hear it, motherfucker sing. No, it's me. I sing, and we'll get into that. Never. But if you hear the singing, it's probably me. I probably wrote it. I'm probably singing it.
All right.
Shout out to all the producers, man. This is the raw over here. This is what happened with family start talking. Happy Thanksgiving is close. Happy Thanksgiving. Hey, happy go spend your money again, Peggins love you. I'm out of luck. I'm chilling. I don't get all that. Let's go to my YouTube channel so I can tell you about all the government stuff and the religious stuff. This is about music. So shout out to Ernest Savage. Michael R. Santana, that's one of my partners. I killed up the list. Bobby B. Blunt. Oh, yeah, Bobby B. Blunt. Hey, shit, look, I'm on too much shit. Shout out to AC, the PD. Just the Facts Free, Big Rat. Free, my nephew, Bo Tiny, that's what he's gonna go by. And everybody else. G13, Mike the Middleman, this is the Homie. Shout out to Earth, DC in the house. We got Sir Black. Nephew Michael, Earth,
Angel.
I don't know about Angel trying to go. I talk to Angel more than through Facebook, and we talk all the time. Every time I do something, he like, every time I see some of his shit, I'm right on it. And that's where everybody in this room goes. If they ever put something up, and I see it on my page, I'm going to immediately like it, share it. And that's how you support your people, really, that is how you support them in a way, because the digital thing is going on now, the streaming, but also get out there and support them. Also, give them $10 or whatever. Like, it don't hurt anybody that much you spending on all that drinking and that shit. And if you can go on their page and like their shit, because I ain't gonna lie, half the time, I just support it and try to push it because I got different fan base, but if I got the money, I'll pay that shit, because really, if you don't even know what you like in real life, so... And I'm not gonna like everything my friends put out, because if the song whack to me, I'm not gonna fucking like that shit.
Right.
So, but overall, I like everything they're doing because they support me, and I like to show that same love and support. Thank you for having me on the show. I'm hungry than a motherfucker. Look, I got so much shit coming, I couldn't plug everything. So, like I said, for those of you I miss, shout out to everybody I miss. I love you. Keep doing what you're doing, especially all my fans out of Singapore, France, Japan, Australia, Russia. Shout out to Nate374. Shout out to Bo in France. Shout out to Jeremy, Super Fresh Radio out in France. Joey Slick out in Japan, joining one. But I can't plug everything. I should have brought a list. Like, please don't fuck with me like that. Or cuss me out on Facebook or something. I'll answer back quick. Send me a deep direct message on Twitter. So at least my stats can go up. That's what all the rest of the fake world is watching.
Links everywhere.
They wouldn't know how many likes and shit you got. I don't fuck who, but what. Hey, it's been a pleasure, man. Thanks for having me on the show.
Yes. Thank you.
All right.
Living bummy, what G's do for Monday? Sex money. money and drugs, the whole enchilada, from jobs to manslaughter to selling your little daughter. Evil sin that us men do will continue, even investing, fraud and big checks in. Cause your son got his gun by a snow stash. Cops are ass caught up in this game when you last, if you ask me. Ain't nothing tax free, got my brother sitting in to have to feed, meditating drastically. I guess that's how it's gotta be, so I focus on it. You know the local zone, welcome to the zone. On the corner, get they stroll on daily. Kept my 9 to 5 and got the dojo selling shady. And everybody's going crazy for revenue. Selling out shit, you caught your homies and play the fool. But I refuse to be a joker, man. You think I play spot them, got them. Now you're going to play it up, man.
Christ is my savior. Remember, I'm on my... It ain't time for that. Look. Right, look. Christ is my savior. Remember, I'm on my worst behavior. I'll kill you, nigga. No need to pull those triggers either. The kid's so dumbed down, there is no reason. I'm back with the scriptures. It's Rachett, my nigga. Don't pose for them pictures. Put some clothes on these bitches. And trust the social media to fuck your whole image. Because I'm varsity, you fucking JV, nigga. So fuck the talking, cut the check and pay me, nigga. This weed got me feeling kinda crazy, nigga. For fucking with this music, I just may be, nigga. In love with the N-word, bang, but I've been a nerd. Seen niggas get it wrong, they been shitted on. West Coast never slept, time to let the babies roam. So please forgive me, I told you I'll be hella high. I see these chemtrails fucking up my vanilla sky. Exhibit blurred speech, leaves a velvety drink. I shop for my groceries, it's the ordinary me. But it's still the same thing, even when I'm OT. A ghetto celebrity catch Rachett in the streets. The Hungry, Hot 16 for y'all. Shout out to Angel Sandoval, Earth 7, DC, Mike the Middleman, T13, Sir Black is up out of here. We got Nephew Michael in the house, Rock Box, and I'm the infamous little Rachett. Willow's coming soon, baby. Don't miss an episode. You'll never see nothing like this ever again. Hip-hop culture, The Hungry, brought to you by Caddick Styles and Apparel. Peace.